One of the key things that any reference management software will do is to help organize your references and research. In this video, I will be showing you how you can organize your references using the group function and how to remove duplicates in your EndNote library. There are two major functions in EndNote that can help manage your references in your EndNote library. The first is to use the group function to organize your references. There are two different groups you can create. The first is the dump group, which is a normal folder, and the other is what EndNote calls the smart group. The second is that EndNote can remove duplicates in your EndNote library. This is an important step to do because having duplicates in your library can confuse EndNote when you are citing references in your Word document. The first thing that EndNote can do to help you organize your library is to create groups where you can organize your references according to topics, modules, chapters, or even based on authors. As mentioned earlier, there are two types of groups. The dump or normal group acts like a normal folder, and the other is the smart group. I will be showing you how to create and use both types of groups. To create the normal or dump group, first, open EndNote. Next, right-click on My Group and select Create Group. You can then name your group according to your needs. For most people, they either name their groups based on module codes, chapters, or topics. To add references into that folder, head to All References in your EndNote library, and then drag and drop the references you want into that group. To remove references from your folder, just head to the group, select the reference you want to be removed, and press delete. The reference will be removed from the folder, but not your EndNote library. The second type of group you can create are the smart groups. What are smart groups? Basically, they are groups with a search filter that can pull out references from your EndNote library that fit a certain criterion. To create a smart group, first, open EndNote. Next, right-click on My Groups and select Create Smart Group. A pop-up will appear, and this is where you key in your criteria for EndNote to filter. Once you're done, click on Create, and EndNote will automatically filter the references that fit that criteria into the smart group. Any new references you add into your EndNote library will be sent to that smart group if it fits the criteria you set. Do note that unlike the normal or dump group, deleting anything in the smart group will also delete it from your EndNote library. The final and most important thing that I'm going to show you in this video is how you can remove duplicates. This is an important function in EndNote, and we at NUS Libraries highly recommend that you do this at the end of the day when you finish searching for references. The reason why this is important is because if you have duplicates in your EndNote library, EndNote may get confused when you start citing references, and it may cite the references wrongly. To remove duplicates, open EndNote, make sure you click on All References first. Next, click on References, and then Find Duplicates. If there are duplicates, EndNote will create a pop-up and ask you to compare the references. If there are duplicates, choose the record you want to keep, and EndNote will delete the other duplicate reference. If there are no more duplicates, EndNote will not show any result. I hope that this video has shown you how you can organize your EndNote library so that you can be more efficient in your research and writing workflow. You can visit the EndNote library guide if you want to know more about EndNote. You can also email us at askalib@nus.edu.sg if you need further assistance.